Hello and welcome back to my channel. Today, I want to start with a little experiment to understand how many coats of Rubio Monocoat you should put on your workpiece. The ones of you who already use Rubio Monocoat might know that the official recommendation of Rubio is to put one coat of Rubio on your workpiece, hence the name, Rubio Monocoat, mono, one coat. And the reason for that is that Rubio reacts with the wood in a very different way than other coatings. And it's a so-called molecular binding. So it reacts with the upper layer of the molecules of the wood and creates the look and feel that you're accustomed to. And so hence, you need only one coat of Rubio on your workpieces. That's in theory. The ones of you who follow my videos might know that I use Rubio for most of my projects. I'm a big fan of Rubio. It's easy to use, to apply, it looks beautiful. It's just like, I use it always. What you might not know is that I actually sometimes use two or three layers of Rubio on my project. I often don't even show it in the videos. And the reason for this is simple. It's all based on an anecdote I want to tell you so you understand where that comes from. I did a project for a friend of mine, a bench, a walnut bench, and I applied Rubio to it. And when I came back and I looked at it, I kind of felt it didn't look really good. Like something was lacking. And so I thought, oh, maybe I didn't apply the coat well. And so I applied a second coat of Rubio. And after that, it looked good. And I was like, okay, apparently that was it. And I gave the bench to my friend. A little bit later, I made for the same friend a couch table, an oak couch table. And I did again, like the Rubio thing, one coat, and it looked good, so I gave it to him. And a couple weeks later, he said, hey, like the table is fantastic. But something weird happened. My kids dropped some water on it and I cleansed it. And afterwards, like the wood was kind of like not as soft as before. So it needed some sanding. And the kids spill water all the time over the bench and that doesn't happen. And it's also my experience that normally when you treat something with Rubio, you can spill liquid on it and it's pretty resistant, water repellent. So that's one of the things I like. And so I thought, okay, maybe that's because I applied two coats, right? I applied two coats to the bench and that's why the bench works well and the couch table doesn't. And based on that anecdote and then case study, right? I started to apply two, sometimes even three layers of Rubio on my projects. And I'm a scientist, and so everybody knows like you shouldn't take such a strong conclusion based on an anecdote, a single case study. Maybe it was other things that led to this effect, right? Maybe oak reacts different than walnut, or maybe it had something to do with temperature, or who knows, right? Could be many things. And so I decided to run an experiment for myself to understand if there is any effect on the numbers of coats of Rubio you put on your lumber with regards to how well it protects against liquids. And I have no clue what the result will be because it's an experiment. I want to know it myself. And so maybe the result is there is no effect. That would be what Rubio says, right? One coat. And if that is the case, I'll publish the video anyway so you don't repeat the same mistake and use multiple layers of Rubio, or you don't repeat the experiment yourself because I already did it. And so I actually would love it if there is no effect because that means I can use only one coat of Rubio, which will speed up the project time and lower the costs because applying multiple layers of Rubio is also a cost factor. So we'll see about that. So here's how we're going to go with this experiment. There are three pieces of elm here. You see them in front of you. They're from the same piece of wood, just cut into different pieces. And I applied Rubio on them actually already a month ago. So I applied Rubio on the three of them, let it cure out for a week, then applied Rubio on two of them, let it cure out for a week, and then applied Rubio on one more and let it cure out. And so here I have the numbers. This is one layer. This here is two layers. I don't know if you see it in the video, and this one here is one, two, three layers. From a visual perspective, and I know this is really hard to see on the video, so apologies for that, but I hope you agree with me, there's no difference. I can't tell apart which piece has been treated with one, two, or three layers. So multiple layers of Rubio apparently really doesn't lead to a visual difference if you apply it well, obviously, due to the way it reacts with the wood, the molecular binding on the upper layer. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to put wine, drops of wine on these three pieces. Wine, first of all, because it is pretty aggressive to the wood, and second, because it is red and so there is coloring in it, and it will be much easier to see what the consequences are. So let's give it a try. I have here a little bit of red wine, not the best, so you don't think that I'm like wasting my good wine on experiments. And I'm going to make sure it's more or less the same size. Okay, that's it. I'm going to let this rest for half an hour, then I'm going to come back and I'm going to try to do a close-up so you see when I clean the different pieces how the result is. We waited for 30 minutes with the wine on the wood. And as you can see, it didn't really move. It looks like exactly as I left it there. And I'm going to take some kitchen paper and just soak up the wine. I see nothing. It's all perfect. Nothing has soaked in. Let me touch it. There is a difference, a slight difference in how it feels. This one here is a little bit rougher than this one here. And this is the smoothest, which would be the one with three layers. Here's the two, and this is the one here. But it's very, very slight, very small difference. It seems like the grain of the wood soaked in a little bit more, but it's not visible. Okay, so the difference here is really super small. I will now, again, put wine on the wood, but this time I'll let it stay on the wood for longer, maybe an hour, to see if that makes a difference. Okay, now 1 hour passed, and I'm going to see if the result is the same as after half an hour. Now we see a little stain is left over on this one here. I'm not sure if you're seeing it, but I'll take a close-up afterwards. Now this one here, two layers. There is also a little stain left over. And the third one, I do also see a little stain that is left over. Let me see if I can show you a close-up. So here you see the wine stain after 1 hour left. This is the one with one layer of Rubio Monocoat. You see there is also a stain here, but if you compare it, it's softer.
but it's still there. And here, the stain is barely visible, but it's still here. If you see, if you can look here, there is a small stain of wine.
Okay, so my summary of this experiment is that there is a small effect of having multiple layers of Rubio regarding how well it protects against liquids. It is clear to me that the one layer only leaves more of a stain, the second one too, the third one is a little bit less. But I have to admit that it's really very small. It's barely visible, even on the camera. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to repeat the experiment, put wine on it, and leave it for multiple hours to see if the effect gets stronger and if there is like more difference we can see or if it remains barely visible. Okay, this has been on the wood for 2 hours now. Enough experiments. I'm going to try to clean up. Okay, there are clearly visible 3 stains here, here, and here. I don't see a big difference between the 3. So I don't think that additional layers of Rubio protect the wood much better than if you have only one. Okay, friends, that was it with this little experiment. I think the answer is you can put one good coat of Rubio on your workpieces and that should be it. Putting additional coats on them will not protect them better from liquids. And so that's good. I'm going to save some time in the future by not doing this anymore. There's one little thing maybe to add. If you notice after adding one coat to your workpiece that it doesn't look the same way that you were expecting, sometimes the second coat helps. And my theory here is that maybe while you putting on the coat on the workpiece, you didn't distribute it well enough. It didn't soak in all the places the same way. And then it's kind of like an opaque looking touch it has. And when you put a second coat on it, that disappears. So I would still pay attention to that. But if after putting one coat on the workpiece, it looks like you want it to look, you are expecting it to look, then I think you're good. So that was it with my little experiment. I hope you liked it. And if you did, thumbs up, subscribe, and see you around.